passages from The Science of Mind by Ernest Holmes on stillness and receptivity, the way is made clear before me, and rise my spirit. I am still and receptive to life, and I let life flow through me into all that I do, say, or think. I shall let my life be what it is, and shall not worry or complain. Of my soul, where complete quiet reigns supreme and where spirit talks to me. I receive. The way is made clear before me. I will not falter, I will not fall. The way of the Spirit is my way, and I am compelled to walk in it. My feet are kept on the path of perfect life, and the way is prepared before me. And that way is a path of peace, of fulfillment, and joy. The way is bright with the light of love and kindness, and the way I tread is a pleasant and a happy one. I see the way and I walk in it. As we continue to breathe in, we ask, arise, my spirit, arise and shine. Let your light illumine my path, and let your wisdom direct my way. Arise, my spirit, arise and shine, and let your light illumine my path, and let your wisdom direct my way. I will follow my spirit and learn. I will sit in the silence and listen and watch, and I will see Spirit's light and hear Spirit's voice. And I will follow Spirit, for in Spirit I find peace. I respond to life, I arise, I shine. Thank you.
Thank you. March snow. And to all of our online viewers on Facebook, thank you for joining us as well. And if you wouldn't mind taking a moment just to share our link on our Facebook page so other people can join us too, that would be absolutely wonderful. So glad to hear you, have you here. And this service will be uploaded to our YouTube page for later viewing if you would like. I'd like to invite you also to do our mission statement with me here to know who we are collectively as the Columbus Center. So stay with me.
We serve the transformation of individual lives through education, spiritual practice, and deep community using spirit and science of mind principles as our compass.
That's very true, that mission statement. We really try to support everybody and their unique journeys and their spiritual paths to love and support you along the way. And please let us know if there's anything we can do to be that for you while you are here with us. I'd like to thank our practitioner, Joni Ballin, for meditation this morning and for holding high watch as well as music with us today. And I'd also like to reintroduce our practitioner, Kirsten Wilcock, to get us started. We now begin our sacred service with the ringing of the bowls. A reading from Ernest Holmes, Creative Mind, page 78. The person who is always glad will surround themselves with people who are happy, and life will be a continual enjoyment. Now let the music take us within.
Still and know. still and know.
After his job ended, like 6 in the evening, And we worked out a way for me to be able to at least go to tryouts and see what happened, right? So this was a really big deal for me. I prepared my song for tryout. I felt really confident. And then when I got to tryouts, I don't know what I had been expecting, but they happened on the stage of a theater. And I had never been on the stage of a theater before. And so I was very, very nervous. I was like a stranger in a strange land, right? It's a whole other world that theater world is. I remember vividly still standing on the edge of the stage, singing my tryout song, and feeling really confident that I had managed to project my voice to the back, which is what they were telling us. That was the goal, get your voice to the back. I felt like I had managed to do that. And so I had to wait then, right? I had to wait to find out who made callbacks. And I was thrilled when I saw that my name was on the callback list, because that meant a guaranteed spot somewhere in the show. And then I had to sort out how I was going to manage to get to rehearsals and get my work study done and all that. And thankfully, I had a lot of support. People helped me put it all together, and I got to go to my callback. Now, callbacks took that fish out of water thing to a whole new level for me, because they wanted to see how comfortable we were on stage, which clearly I wasn't. So we were told to sing along to the song. The show we were in was Godspell. They told us to sing along to the song we were about to play, and they were just going to watch us. And that was all the instruction that we were given. So they started the music, and I'm standing there at the front in my little corner, and I start to sing with them. I'm very nervous about this. It's amazing how all of that liveliness and spirit movement just flows and creates magnificence. It's moving in a way that it's hard to imagine trying to force creating, because we can't, because it's created in spirit's movement. I could listen to musicians perform live probably all day. If they would pay me to do it, that would be my job. It's amazing, right? And one of the other amazing things about music and creating with other people, whether it's music or it's theater or it's any other creative expression, is that when we are in the flow of that creative process, it is fun. There is nothing in the world that is like it. It is so full of joy and expression, because that is spirits moving in and through us. That callback I had for Godspell was not fun for me. It wasn't fun because I wasn't comfortable yet in my body. I wasn't comfortable in my voice. I wasn't comfortable in the space of the theater. But I can tell you, as I kept showing up there, as I kept participating in the rehearsals and with that group of people, that in time, I came to grow into that. I came to grow into that comfort. I came to trust in the people I was with and the space I was in. And I ended up having a lot of fun. I ended up having more fun during that time than I think I had in my entire life up until that point. It was so amazing an experience to be part of. I found a new community, new friends, new talents in myself, new dreams to have. And although I don't think I had those words for it at the time, I just felt more alive. I was having fun doing something that was meaningful to me, creating something with other people that was beautiful and brought joy to other people. And that was an amazing thing to be part of. The joy I experienced and my personal growth in that time, it only occurred because of the support I had. It occurred because the teachers were willing to let me work later or different hours, because the director took a risk on this senior who had never been on a stage before, because the people who were their own little knit community of theater people welcomed me into their circle. And all of those things allowed me to experience something new and wonderful and life-giving for myself. Mm-hmm. Ernest Holmes, who we credit with kind of synthesizing this philosophy that we live in, the science of mind, he said, "The present moment can never provide us with more joy than we are able to embody." The experience of being in Godspell for me, it cracked open my ability to experience joy. It opened that vessel up for me to be able to experience more joy than I had been able to experience before that. But over the years, I have allowed that vessel to shrink. Right? I have different life priorities, exhaustion, isolation, this little thing called the pandemic that's come up. It has limited my ability to participate in some of the things that bring me joy. And I think about the times in my life where I have had the most joy post-Godspell into my adulthood. There are times that were full of spontaneity, times of connection with other people, times of playfulness. For me, they often involve music, but for a lot of people, it doesn't need to, right? Well, one of my very favorite joyful memories was on my wedding day, we had hired a marimba band to do our music for us. Ourselves in a place like I have recently, where it feels like my vessel for joy has shrunk, or we don't really know how to play in our lives anymore, then it's time for some honest self-reflection. It's time to remember those times in our life that have brought us that joy, to remember what it was about them that brought that joy forward for us, to remember that we are unique expressions of the divine, and in that alone is joy. In our philosophy, we believe that spirit is continuously creative, and that we are an expression of that spirit. And as such, we are always able to be in that flow of creativity, in that flow of spirit as us creating in the world. And we say that the qualities of spirit are love, life, light, peace, power, beauty, and joy. Joy, just as much as any of the others. We don't talk about some distant God in the heavens who's passively observing us and taking notes about our judgment. We talk about a personal God who's relational, who's intimate, who expresses through us in our lives, expresses as us in the world. And because that creative, powerful, immensely magnificent God and the innermost God that is me in the world is one and the same God, then we have a lot to be joyful about. To know joy is to know that God, to know spirit. So we have this theme for the month of March, the theme of play. And this week specifically being about play in community, which is why I brought up that whole God spell story, because for me that really captured that awakening for me into joy through community. But as we age, many of us stop playing. We stop doing many of the things that have been that source of joy for us. Maybe we get bogged down in family or work and other responsibilities. We get exhausted and busy, and things get a little more difficult to accomplish the tasks we have set before us, let alone to have the free time we might want to have to go do things that are fun and silly and playful. But connecting with each other, and especially connecting with each other in a fun and playful way, it's really invaluable. It's part of what unites us together, sharing joy, sharing creation. And there's a special moment of vulnerability that happens when we enter that place of joyfulness, when we enter that place of creativity with another person. There's a place where our heart is wide open. If you can think to yourself of a memory when you had such immense joy in your life, and the vulnerability that actually comes with that, of being just cracked wide open. It's totally present moment. There's no worrying about the past. There's no anticipating what's in the future. It's just right here, right now, in this experience with each other, in this experience of joy. And because it is such a remarkable place, that joy, it's also a place where great healing can happen. So as we play together, as we experience joy together, and as we reveal God to each other through that joy, we create a safe place for each other. We create a place for healing for each other. In the company of joy, we are loved and accepted by each other, but we are in the company, in the presence of God. Perhaps you are fortunate enough to have a friend who's been able to keep that quirkiness and playfulness alive. Perhaps you yourself are one of those people. And it's wonderful for me whenever I'm in the presence of those people, because it kind of reminds me of who I am. It reminds me of that part of myself that I don't always tap into. You know, people who walk on the curb instead of the sidewalk, or they splash the water up out of the fountains when you walk by outside, or they sing to the radio as loud as they want to, and they don't care what anybody thinks, you know, those kind of things. They can Ernest Holmes again. He said, if we feel that we're simple onlookers and not participants in our life, then we should rediscover the youthful spirit of childlike joy, which gives us energy, happiness, security, and faith we had as children. So pandemic life is normalizing now. Some say we're even entering this post-pandemic time. We're able to be free from our masks now, and things are opening back up. So I invite you to think if there are opportunities for connection with yourself, ways of connecting with other people, where you can re-engage with joy and play in ways that maybe we've been lacking over the last couple years. I invite you to take some time and actually make a plan for yourself of some way to introduce a new joy, a new play with somebody into your life. Maybe it's going to one of those places where they have the pottery made and you get to paint it, or it's going to the trampoline park and just bouncing around like wild and free. Maybe it's taking a glass blowing class or going skydiving or cave splunking. I mean, there are so many options. If you want to keep it a little more chill, you could plan a meal with your friends and make some ground rules. No complaining. This is a meal where we're going to celebrate our joys and our blessings. Maybe everybody comes with a funny story to share or a joke. Let's bring some joy back into our relations, into our communities. My sister introduced me to a game a couple years ago that's a collaborative game. These are becoming more and more popular, where you're not competing against each other, but you're working together toward a goal. Maybe it's time to get together with some friends and play a game. You work together to free yourselves from a sinking island. There are all kinds of fun and exciting ways to connect with each other, enjoy, and play. And it's time to do that. It's time to do that. And then here at our Columbus Center, we are thriving into our next stage of growth and being. We have our annual meeting today from 1 to 3, as we heard in our announcements. And the annual meeting is a time to reflect on our past and a time to plan for our future. And so I invite you to be part of that, to join that link with us this afternoon, and to come be part of shaping this community. Come with your ideas for how we can manifest joy with each other, how we can show up as God for each other in this community and for the greater community around us. Be like John the Baptist, and let's prepare the way. Let's use this time to prepare the way for what we are becoming together in this community and in this world. So I hope we'll see you there. I hope you come with your passion and your joy and your readiness to show up and create something magnificent and beautiful and joyful together that none of us could create alone, but that we can create together in spirit. From that place, let us join together in prayer. I know that there is one incredible, remarkable spirit, that one who is the creative force of all that is, and that one who is for me, as for all people, my indwelling source, my expression of spirit in the world. I know that I have the opportunity through this God who is joy and his play to experience those things in my own life, to dance and laugh, to play and connect with other people. that creative force, knowing that as I speak, the Spirit says yes. Together we say.
And so it is.
Gratitude below me. Why not?